Go versus Rust. Which is the better language to learn between Go and Rust? Which offers the best performance? Which offers the best opportunities? Which should you learn? We'll dive into all that and more. First, let me explain how we'll be approaching this. First, we'll look at the differences in philosophy and mindset between each language. Second, we'll explore the features of both languages and their relative strengths and weaknesses. Third, we'll examine what the statistics say about the difference between the two languages in terms of developer experience, attractiveness, and salary. And then I'll tell you what I recommend. But whatever language you choose, I've provided links in the description to helpful resources for learning them. Let's dive in. What are the differences in philosophy between the two languages? We have our contenders. In the blue corner goes friendly gopher. In the, well, brownish red corner, Rust's unofficial mascot, Ferris the Crab. And there you have it already. These logos, names, mascots, and even colours tell us a lot about the differences between the two languages. Let's start with Go. Go's name and logo express speed and efficiency. The three lines make the text look like two wheels in rapid motion. Go's mission, as expressed by their brand book, is to bring order to the complexity of creating and running software at scale. Let's unpack that. Creating and running at scale. What does that mean? Go's goal is to be simple enough to be used for prototyping and efficient enough to be the language of the cloud. Go's brand book also says it wants to be thoughtful, simple, efficient, reliable, productive, and friendly. These values are expressed in the friendly, cuddly mascot, the gopher. Rust mascot, Ferris, certainly has a friendly smile, but it's prickly though, as is Rust's logo. Rust's goal is not to be friendly or simple. After all, crabs walk sideways. Perhaps the best way to explain Rust's values is to tell its origin story. Graydon Hoare was a programmer at Mozilla. Coming home one night, he found an out-of-service elevator. He lived on the 21st floor. The software had crashed due to a memory error. This goaded Hoare into creating a language that prevents memory management crashes. Rust is designed to be solid, like the crab. And the name Rust also conveys this. It doesn't refer to the oxidation of iron, but to an exceedingly resilient fungi. Now, what are the differences and common strengths between the features of Go and Rust? Go and Rust both focus on memory management, on concurrency and performance. However, their approach is very different. This too reflects their philosophy. Allow me to demonstrate. First, let's talk about memory management. Go has a helpful garbage collector that tries to clean up unused memory references for you. Rust, on the other hand, enforces the concept of ownership and borrowing to prevent you from coding memory bugs. Go helps you. Rust forces you to do the right thing. Second, concurrency and multithreading. In a similar fashion, Go provides easy-to-use Go routines. These are lightweight threads that allow you to write concurrent code without worrying about thread management. Rust, on the other hand, uses basically system threads. Here, Rust's ownership concept helps prevent thread locking errors and data races. Again, Go makes your life easier. Rust teaches you to do the right thing. Third, performance. Go has a small memory footprint and is optimized for modern multi-core processors. Its syntax is simple and concise. This makes it easy to learn and to start working with. Go does the right thing for you by default. Rust, on the other hand, provides something called zero-cost abstractions. Basically, there is no magic. The code that you write faithfully reflects the code that the compiler produces, and vice versa. This means less runtime overhead, which helps you build high-performance applications. In short, Go hides the complexity for you. Rust helps you understand it by exposing it. Now, what do developers think of the languages? Let's look at the statistics provided by the Stack Overflow Developer Survey. Go and Rust have similar popularity levels at about 13% overall among developers. Developers' opinions of the languages, however, show a difference. 84% of the developers who used Rust last year want to use it again this year. For Go, that number is lower at 60%. The survey also shows that 30% of those who didn't work with Rust last year want to work with it this year. That number is 20% for Go. In short, Rust is globally more desirable among developers than Go. But what about on the job market? Well, if we look at the reported salaries, developers working in both languages report a mean yearly salary of about $90,000. Go developers are slightly above, and Rust developers are slightly below. A word of caution here. These values are reported globally. The situation in your local job market will vary. Now, After having explored the philosophies, the features, and the statistics of Go and Rust, what are my recommendations? Well, let's recap. Go is designed to be simple and friendly. Rust is designed to be as hard as possible to break. They're two teachers. One is encouraging and warm, a kindergarten teacher. The other is demanding and harsh, a drill sergeant. One makes life easier for you. The other makes you work harder for your own good. Go and Rust also have different primary use cases. Go is meant for the cloud, for server applications. Rust is meant for low-level or high-performance or embedded applications. Which is the best for you? Well, that will depend on two things: who you are and what you're trying to build. Go is easier to pick up. Rust requires more effort, but provides greater rewards in the long run. What kind of teacher do you need? Do you need encouragement? Are you building for the cloud? Well, I recommend Go. Do you need a demanding teacher who will push you forwards? Do you want to build performance-intensive or low-level embedded software? I recommend Rust. Whatever language you choose, if you're looking to pick up the basics, I recommend you go to Exercism, which gives you simple challenges to help you learn. And if you're looking for projects to help you dive deep while learning how reference technologies like Git, Docker, or HTTP servers work, I recommend CodeCrafters. I've provided links for both in the description. But whatever path you choose, let me know how it's going, and I'll see you in the next video.